You're next in line for the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
With park president and CEO, Matt Eckert.
That's a lot of wasted time.
Fourth-generation owners, Lauren Crosby.
We have to laugh through the pain.
And Leah Cook.
The claws come out.
Director of attractions, Eric Retz.
How do you think we feel, lady?
And director of communications, Paula Wernie.
I shovel other things, man.
Yes, you do.
Now stow your loose articles, buckle up,
and please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we are back. Welcome back to the official Holiday World Podcast. This is podcast episode number 054. Today is Friday, March 23rd. It's National Puppy Day.
Aww.
Does everybody know that?
I don't know.
Puppy Day. Puppy Day?
I do now.
We have some really cute photos of Holodog holding puppies. Mm-hmm. So check out our Facebook page if you haven't. Well, actually, I haven't posted it yet. So they won't hear this till after I've done it. So
we're a minute inside the mind of Paula.
Yes, that's exactly what goes on. So check out our Facebook page. The title of today's podcast episode is the one with a mix it up menu. Tammy Berg is back.
Yay, Tammy.
Tammy, ooh, don't be quiet now.
We just scolded her.
Sit up nice and close to your microphone, yeah. Darling. And Tammy is a manager with food and beverage, and she is the person who presents to our full-time staff what's new on the menus, as well as, you know, what are the things that aren't coming back and that sort of thing. So we thought it'd be great to bring her back for the second year in a row to talk about food. So welcome, Tammy.
Thank you very much. I'm excited.
I can tell you are. She's got her list, so take it away, Tammy.
And we're also very excited about the menu changes this year. So I'm going to start with cabana meals. Mm-hmm. So if you're going to rent a cabana this summer, you want to check out those premium
meals. Hot Squad should get a cabana together and sample all the menus because they really look good.
Can't enter sweepstakes, but we can get a cabana.
Yes. She didn't say we could get a cabana. She just said we could sample the food.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we could get a cabana, but
we could sample the food in a cabana.
You will be invoiced for your portion. Tammy's like, oh yeah, I remember this bunch.
Yeah. Well, I'm just thinking you would be back. An intimidating bunch to deliver food to at a cabana.
Are you serious?
Are you saying we're judgmental?
What do you think we're going to do?
Well, no.
I like both your macaroni
shirts.
And cheeses.
You know how yellow polos are very intimidating.
We'll come incognito.
I know when I walked in it was the Voyage gift shop one time, and as I walked in the door and it was pretty quiet, I heard yellow shirt. Somebody was like alerting everybody. It's like, am I scary? Because I guess so. But
crazy.
Anyway, but nobody was doing anything because I thought, what am I supposed to be catching you doing if somebody feels the need? Oh, I told Vanessa she was not pleased. Why are they doing that? It's like, I don't know. Because everybody looked like they were doing their job and the shop looked great. So, but there is something about that yellow shirt that makes people
panic.
Pay attention. Okay, Tammy, let's try it again.
Yes. Okay. So we're going to be adding a chicken tender platter this year. So you'll have 15 tenders. It'll be sweet barbecue, buffalo, and then plain. And that'll include French fries. So that'll be new. Chicken tenders are very popular at the park. So we
love our chicken tenders.
I love 15 of them. That's exciting.
We'll That's supposed to be for a family, Eric.
I'm a family.
A family of one.
A family of one. I have a cat. She likes chicken. Let's do this.
Oh, another exciting one. We'll have a chilled shrimp platter. So that is new.
Oh, wow.
Yes. We do not offer shrimp out in the park. So this is that's the only place you
if
can
you
get shrimp.
If you want shrimp,
you have to get exclusive. A cabana.
That's where to get it. And we took photos of it, I don't know, maybe 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. And that's a whole lot of shrimp.
It is.
It is truly a platter. It's not like some little tiny dessert plate.
No.
It is a platter. Platter of shrimp.
You're getting shrimp.
Yeah.
Then we're also, our fruit tray, we're making that bigger and better this year. That'll have cantaloupe, pineapple, oranges, grapes,
they look kind of
strawberries.
Artistic.
It is. It's very different for us, so it's exciting.
I could never work in foods in that case. If we're going artistic with our food, it's like, leave me where I am.
Yeah, we always take photos of stages of, okay, now you do this.
So they'll have a roadmap for the people that are making it.
Exactly. So
that's smart.
Yeah, so very easy. And we're actually training that crew this weekend, so they will be ready to go on Monday.
Hey. Ooh, so we can have a
sample samples next week.
Okay, all right. So Dippin' Dots, big favorite around the park. We're going to have a new flavor this year. It is going to be brownie batter.
Yes.
Ooh. That is one flavor we've never carried, so that's new to the park.
Did we sample that?
Yes, we did.
Okay. Lauren remembers.
It was amazing.
Leah was
tell me about it, please. Yes.
It was so good. I ate all of it.
We're also going to bring back our flavor of the month for Dippin' Dots. So each month we'll swap out our sixth flavor at the stands so that just never know what might pop up. So
ooh.
Yeah. Reason to so come back.
That's right.
That's right. Yeah. Just for the Dippin' Dots.
Only month. That.
Just maybe a that.
Come for the roller coasters, stay for the Dippin' Dots. Our new slogan.
Hand-dipped ice cream. We're going to stick with the frozen items right now. So we're going to have three new flavors available at the park up at Kringle's Ice Cream. So we're going to be adding coffee, moose tracks, and praline and cream.
Whoa. Mm.
So those are butter pecan is going away, Thunderbird, and then turtle tracks.
So pralines and cream, is that similar to butter pecan?
It is. And I'll tell you, I was really skeptical on that one.
Praline's like chocolate, because, right?
No.
No.
Oh. No, everything's like chocolate for you. Chicken tenders are like chocolate.
No, it's praline.
Praline cream, it's very similar to butter pecan, but it has caramel. Okay. In, so
that sounds actually better.
It actually is. I fought for it. I fought for butter pecan because that's my favorite flavor.
My
but
dad
I did a
side
by side taste test and I did prefer.
What does one do to fight for a menu item? What goes into that? Is there yelling?
Tell me. Throwing because it
involves
a lot of
passive aggression.
Is a campaign, a hashtag, t-shirts. I'm
picture
kidding.
A street fight with like ice cream scoops.
Picture like Sharks and Jets now.
For every item, it's a little bit different. Praline, for those, praline. Our new director, Vern.
I like praline.
He wanted to bring in these three flavors. I was cool, like, well, let me go ahead and bring praline. In butter pecan as well to taste.
You're like so I have to get sliding it under the
exactly.
radar.
Yeah. You know, I'm sneaky sometimes. Sorry, Vern, but
we all have that figured out, Tammy.
Do you? Okay, dang.
We got your number.
Vern thinks you're wonderful, so use it, baby.
So, but I bowed out whenever that.
Now, speaking of ice cream, now that we're in the cold section, you brought a little. What is this thing? A cooler, I guess. Full of cold things.
Yes.
That I'm.
Which is typically in a cooler.
Oh, did anybody want any of these?
Yes. And so why don't you tell us what we're sampling?
This will shut us up for a while.
Okay. Yeah. And that way you can finish.
And I'll have the microphone to myself.
That's why I thought sooner versus later. This will.
Take the mic and go.
It's like the pacifier. Shove it in their mouth, then you can talk.
Oh, you know.
So do you want to explain what these are?
I sure will. I brought a cooler of ice cream novelties. So anything from. Push pops. Totally tubular.
Oh, I love push pops.
And there's fudge bars.
There's ice cream sandwiches. Anything and everything you can think of. We're going to have a dollar cart out by the front gate this summer. So
I bet you can do
if you're
that.
Leaving the park and your kiddos are wanting one more snack, but you don't want to wait in a long line, just walk up there and grab one for the road.
And it's cash only, right?
Cash only,
so
yes.
So those lines will move.
Yes.
Fling me a buck at me and I'll... Something cold back at you. That's why I'm not
that
food.
Sounds dangerous. There's a lot of options.
So it won't be open all day, just in the evenings. So check it out if you want one more treat for the road. So
this one has 50% vitamin C.
Awesome.
Hooray. All about providing healthy too. Options here, Eric. Well, I'm going to have to do that one because it's good
That's
for you.
Sherbert. Yeah.
Oh, let's be careful.
There's no good way to do this. I'm sorry.
That's probably the worst.
There's nothing. I mean, it's not going to fall out.
Okay.
Sorry, Tammy.
No, you're okay. A few other things, just some random ones before I get to the big reveals. Yeah.
That was so dramatic,
right?
Because Eric wasn't at our meeting on Monday.
Oh, he didn't.
So I'm learning with our listeners.
Well, I will comes be doing to our an encore presentation. Oh, yeah.
Leah is also, but she's I'm not also, reacting.
I missed one.
Oh, because Leah wasn't here either.
No.
I've got the thing called class.
Yeah, Leah's working on her master's degree.
Class at school. I thought you were like talking down to us. I have class.
Also that, but.
It did sound like that.
As opposed to you.
We'll treasure always.
Oh, goodness.
Fast, Tammy, fast.
Okay, I'm sorry. I can't jump in very quick. So for those of you that love hot dogs, we are moving to an all-beef hot dog this year. So if that's something that you, a big change for the park. So if you like those. At Plymouth Rock, we're going to be adding a turkey bowl.
I'm excited about that.
That's
that
pretty
awesome.
Tasty.
Oh, what?
Yeah. Turkey bowl.
So you'll get two scoops of mashed potatoes. Mm-hmm. We'll put... our sliced turkey on top, gravy.
Sounds like a pita non-inspired sport.
A pita non.
Wait, what?
It's all of the great things from bowling Thanksgiving in one bowl.
This is kind of a replacement for my barbecue parfait that you took away from me a couple years ago.
Yeah. I'm sorry about that.
I know. You took away from me.
The turkey bowl sounds really good.
It is.
What's it like to be in a role where people constantly guilt you over menu items that have left?
Oh, it can be tough. I'm not going to lie.
People are very passionate about their food, as you can see from us all stuffing our faces
right now. Tammy is a living, breathing person who has feelings, and we just
say really mean things to Tammy.
This is like, what?
Well,
you got rid of my parfait. It's all your fault.
Before I did my presentation, do we talk about the things that we removed from the menu? And I was like, no, let's not even talk about those. I was like, no, I feel I need to because I want to rip off the band-aid,
let everybody start the grieving process. Passive aggressive.
The whole peach tea thing came back to you from a few years ago, right? We had somebody that was pretty upset about that.
Yeah, and I didn't even actually remove the product from the bowl. I know,
but people thought you were, and it was.
And it is still here.
Oh, yes, definitely. Yes. Yeah.
Moving forward.
Yeah. No worries.
Lesson learned. Don't even talk about it.
If I'm still there 50 years from now, peach tea will be as
even if you have to make up yourself, yes. It's no longer available. You will make it every morning.
I will do what I have to. I don't want to suffer the wrath of the full-time staff. We're also going to add another mini meal, which is our kids' meals that we added last year for kiddos that are 5 and under. We're going to be adding a grilled cheese down at Wilde Bistro.
Tasty.
So,
yum.
Yeah. And we're making that in a panini press. So
it looks really awesome.
Yeah. Very tasty.
Now, if you're 6 and older, can you get that?
Or yes, you definitely can.
You don't have
can.
To show your birth certificate or something,
no,
right?
Okay. No.
But it's recommended. It's kind of the right amount of food for a 5-year-old.
Exactly. Yeah. The portion's a lot smaller. So you also get French fries or applesauce with that. Mm. So yeah, the portions are definitely smaller, which is why we call them our mini meals for kiddos.
Very good.
So we have 4 stands that are really changing their menus this year. We are adding a lemon shake-up stand. So
I'm really excited about that too.
Mm. Isn't that like your mom's favorite? No. Am I remembering correctly, Lauren and Leah?
You are correct. Lemon shake-ups and saltwater taffy. That's like the fair food.
That's when we went to the state fair together when your dad was honored.
Yeah. I'm sure those are the 2 things she had to have.
We went there straight, and it's like, there's 2 things. She goes, I'll pay. And I thought, oh, I can pay. But, you know, it's like, I'll pay. And I had my first lemon shake-up, and I don't know how much taffy she had, but she brought like a year's supply. She was a happy gal.
Sounds about right.
That was funny.
So the lemon shake-up stand, that'll be in the 4th of July section outside of Alamo. So you'll have to check that one out.
Go get a lemon shake-up and then come see a show at Hoosier.
Oh, there.
That's right. Chances are you'll run into Lori Cook and probably Sawyer too, right?
Possibly, yeah.
You coming to all the shows.
So another stand that we're changing up is, it's now called the Snack House. It's up by the Thunderbird roller coaster. So it's going to have some hand-dipped ice cream. We're going to move the cheese curds up there. So if you're a cheese curd fan, don't go to Goblin. Head up to the Thunderbird area. We're also adding foot-long corn dogs.
Sounds intimidating.
I think it sounds fun. That's
a lot of food.
A corn dog can never be too long.
I almost asked her not to talk about keep talking.
Because we're so immature.
We'll also be adding, we'll have loaded waffle fries at that location. So we'll have chili cheese and then chicken.
At the Snack House?
Not chicken. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Man, that place is going to be a place to be.
So I'll have ranch, bacon, and cheese as well.
I just love you saying that with like
a mouthful. Waffle bacon ranch.
A mouthful.
Waffle bacon ranch.
Waffle bacon ranch.
The waffle fries themselves, even just by themselves, are really good.
Yeah, they're very tasty. They're
I can attest. I had very tasty. Way too many on my
I love waffle fries. We offered samples to our staff after the meeting on Monday that you didn't go to, Eric.
Yeah.
My bad, Eric. Sorry.
I knew I'd hear about it here.
Eric, how's your 50% vitamin C bar?
I feel so energized. Right?
You look energized. Oh, it's dripping. It's dripping.
I was like, quick, hurry.
Hello.
Oh, I just got the best picture of you.
I need to approve it.
Not this time, honey. Keep going there, Dan.
Photo approval on all social media.
Paper towel or
something. I know. I'm like, I need to throw away my...
Yeah. Oh.
We don't have a paper towel, but we have a piece of paper.
It's like a foods contract.
You just dripped, I think. Oh.
So we are also bringing Icy back to the park this year, and we will have an Icy mix-up stand there at the entrance to the Splash and Safari.
I'm so excited.
So there will be 12 different flavors you can choose from. So
yes, we guessed one of them.
Yeah. It's going to be Big Red.
It's happening.
And by mix it up, you can mix the flavors. Is that correct? Or layer the flavors?
You sure can. Okay. Yeah, whether you buy a cup or we have a refillable yard bottle that you can purchase. Yeah, you can just... get however many flavors you want, and they stack on top of each other. It's not a product.
So if you want all 12 flavors in your yard cup,
you can do
you
that.
You will do that?
Yes, you sure can.
That is service.
It'll be a tight fit because the product does, it doesn't just drip out of the machine. It comes
I'm like
out
picturing.
So
I'm just like picturing a 12-layer Icy, a foot-long corn dog, and a platter of shrimp.
That's like the perfect day.
That's like my heaven.
Where's your chicken finger platter?
Yeah, oh where's yeah.
As an appetizer. There's got to be chocolate somewhere.
The praline.
Oof.
And in the water park, we will now out have Sam's Barbecue. So that
yeah.
one
yeah. Yes. Sorry, Sam.
Good stuff at this place. I'm really excited about
Matt's
this one.
Matt's eyes just get very big right
for
there.
For real.
So we will have smoked chicken wings, and those will have a barbecue dry rub on those. And we'll have pulled pork sandwiches.
We tried those Monday too, Eric.
Mm.
And Leah will have sausage on a stick, so it's not a foot long, but so I don't want you to be afraid. No worries.
And roasted corn.
Yes, we are going to have roasted corn there, turkey legs.
The big turkey legs are coming back.
They sure are. And a southern style nacho. So that'll have pulled pork, sour cream. It will have
at the Alamo or at the Sam's.
Just suddenly,
pay attention. Oh, sorry.
No. He's too
I feel like he was actually just
about
checked
sausage.
Out for a second and that got him back in.
And I just heard southern nachos.
Southern nachos. That's
now, good. What makes them southern?
Pulled pork.
I'm sorry, I'm asking really hard questions first thing in the morning.
She had
Boy,
started
did she
to
give me a look
before we interrupted.
Because yeah. they're full of southern foods.
Yeah. Southern comfort.
Like spicy
food.
And stuff.
Yeah. Sure. Southern yeah. barbecue.
Yeah. Pulled yeah. pork, barbecue sauce, sour cream.
That sounds delicious.
Chopped pickles, chopped onions.
Ooh, chopped so. Pickles.
Interesting.
Yeah, that's intriguing to me when you said that the other day. I thought, that sounds pretty good.
So,
a little chopped tasty. Pickle thing on it. It's like,
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not a pickle person. So
I love pickles.
I love pickles.
Pickles and barbecue go well together, too.
Yeah. We have pickles
on
stick.
What is it with pickles?
I would get those
I
all the
put it
time.
On everything. I not here,
pickles.
But...
Because pickles yeah. are the bomb.
Pickle.
Pickles are good.
Pickles are the what?
The bomb. They're good mom. For you.
And they have electrolytes.
They're good for you.
They rehydrate
pickles
you.
Pickles are good for
yeah.
you?
Yeah, because they're cucumbers.
They have a lot of salt in them, don't they?
Well.
But there's electrolytes in there, and they help rehydrate you.
So it's like a push pop.
So it's green and sour.
Without the vitamin C.
Yeah, so it's got...
I may
good.
Or may not know people.
Oh, yeah. Well, thank you for keeping us healthy, Tammy.
Oh,
yeah,
you're
Tammy. Those southern nachos sound like a great healthy option.
We do what we can here at Holiday World Splash and Safari.
Oh, wow.
And we'll also have crinkle cut french fries at that location.
Yes.
So, so that's the only location that will carry that product. So those are our big changes for this year. Gosh. We're very excited.
Wow.
I think it's really cool too, so that there's excited. Multiple options of fries. You've got the waffle fries, the crinkle cut, or is it those two? Or is there
and then
enough?
We have our seasoned straight cut fries I feel like at the majority of the locations.
Yeah. See, I feel like a lot of places just have one type of fry.
And there's cheese curds, which is not a potato, but still.
Yeah. So there's a lot
of
options.
I lump it in the same category.
Yes.
Fried sides.
Tammy, thank you for,
fried sides, welcome. Yeah.
Thank
for
you.
Bringing us up. To, anybody have any questions for Tammy? Because she's right here and she's got one foot out the door.
Well, I'm,
she's getting
I'm
ready to run.
Her office neighbor. I'm right next to her. So I get the real scoop when I go back.
Oh.
Yeah.
Scoop of what? Praline?
We get some preferential treatment down there.
I laugh some days. I'll hear them talking and they'll be talking about seahorses and we'll be talking about cheese curds. You know, it's just so
you just never know.
Yeah, all the departments are so different at the park. It's just fun to hear what
I know we're too loud because I'll just hear like Tammy's door slam.
I do
and
not
I'll be
slam
like, sorry.
It.
No, I'm just kidding.
I quietly close it.
Yep.
A little push
it closes
nonetheless. Put a little emphasis on that. Well, thank you very much. And now Leah is going to magically transform to the other
end
of the table.
Thanks for the treats, Tammy.
You're welcome.
Yes, thank you for everything you do, Ms. Berg.
You're welcome.
And we're going to move Leah over to her microphone because she's been sharing with Sister Lauren. I thought that went very well. I thought there was lots of good sharing.
Have you guys always done well at sharing? My daughters do not at all.
You haven't been good sharers?
My daughters don't even want to share space.
I think there were times in our life when we were and times when we weren't.
Yeah, I feel
you
like
you guys have a really good relationship.
We did not share well.
We do, yes now we do.
Yeah, I think that's what happened.
When they were younger, they did not. I even remember that.
Me and my brother like fought all the time, and now that we're older, it's like, yeah, I get it.
That's what I keep trying to tell my girls. One day you guys will be best friends, but they're not believing me.
Yeah.
I feel like I've told your daughters that before, and they're like, nope.
Yep.
There was a period of probably, 2 years where Leah and I like literally hated each other.
Truth.
Oh,
that
really?
Was during the days when Lauren was responsible for driving me to school. Because at that time, I was a very punctual person. I'm less punctual now.
And at the time, I was not punctual.
And now
I am.
Ain't life funny that way?
She had all the power.
She had all the power because she could drive.
Yeah. Yes.
And she caused you to be late.
Yes.
And
there were many times when my parents were finally like, fine, we have to drive you because Lauren's not going to make it on time anyway.
Oh, I had a problem with waking up on time.
Yeah.
Or just waking up in general.
Or mom would wake
Mornings
her up.
Are hard.
And then she would
talk to me. She would talk to me. She would sometimes come downstairs, like, because my room was downstairs and everyone else's was upstairs. She would come downstairs, look at me, talk to me. I would sit up in bed and talk to her, carry on a conversation. And she would leave and I would go back to sleep. And then whenever she actually like woke me up later because she realized I was still asleep, I had zero recollection of that conversation happening. That happened on a regular basis.
That's my oldest. Yeah. And I intentionally every now and then, because I wake her up in the mornings. I usually have to wake her up 4 or 5 times. So the past like 2 weeks, I've done this and then I just let her go. Then I wake her up 5 minutes before she has to leave. That's harsh on a 16-year-old that has to get ready for school.
But that's the punishment,
that's
right?
That's the punishment. I'm like, you get 5 minutes, you got to go.
Yeah, you're not even ready.
Wow.
Yeah.
But it got to a point where...
But it happened like 5 times. You think she'd learn. She doesn't.
She's like, this is a sweet gig.
I've heard that
No, she's really upset about it every day. But
I've heard that the school hours though, are really rough on teenagers.
Yes. Like, there have been many studies.
What is it, 9 to 2?
And you live in the...
No, it's 8 to 3.
Yeah.
Oh, what kind of school did I go to?
And you live in the Eastern time zone.
It's like 10 till 8.
Our school's 7:58
to 2:50. 2 or 1.
I thought it was 2.
Yeah.
But bizarre.
Also, me and my podcasts have learned that people who live on like the western side of a time zone tend to like cities overall tend to be less prosperous than ones on the east sides of like time zones.
So you've got both here
because of the sun.
Yeah, because the world starts at 8 o'clock regardless.
Oh, that's so weird
in your time zone. And so by living in the central time zone, we gain kind of an extra hour there.
And thank you, Lee, because that is the perfect segue into our amusing.
I was like,
wow, this is perfect. Because the first note for our amusings is actually a correction. I don't know that we've ever had to come back and make a correction from one episode to the next, but indeed we must. During our last episode, we, quote unquote, mistakenly reported that Florida was trying to do away with daylight saving time.
I didn't say that.
I didn't either.
No, you did. You did.
I
read a news article.
I thought I saw that.
Indeed. It is the opposite. They are trying to make a change so that they're on daylight saving time year round.
Sorry. Okay, they're trying to do away with the time change.
Sorry.
Right. They want to be on daylight saving time. And we do apologize for our error. And in trying to go back and see exactly who we is.
It was me.
Who we is. It wasn't just you. I went back and listened to some of the last podcast episode, and I thought it might help explain things.
Oh, no.
I honestly don't even remember talking about this at all.
I vaguely remember talking about Florida.
I remember seeing the article.
Not only listen to it, but listen to perhaps the condition that the pod squad was in.
I used to not change it back, but that was also whenever I was in college.
Why are you on slow-mo?
Yeah. It's half speed.
I would drive back and forth. Yeah. So then it was like even more confusing. Like sometimes
I'll wait till you hear you.
Me? Sometimes yeah. I it's wouldn't bad. Be.
Which is even more confusing here because of the time zones.
Okay, let me pause this for a second. The other day, Lauren's husband Michael comes running into my office. You've got to hear this. And I guess there's some seasonal folks who...
No, you know, I knew about this on Sunday. Jacob Roberts told me, and he's like, sorry, I didn't want to offend you. I was like, you could have shown me this weeks ago. But he didn't play. He just played a little. I was like, oh, I'll have to do that. And I have
Michael came to my office. I'm like, this is awesome. You got to play this for Paula.
Yeah, the other Eric's like, maybe I'll start listening now. And it's like, oh,
well, you're going to have to carve out half twice as much time.
Yeah, I know. Like, that means instead of like 2 hours, it's going to be 4 hours. Yeah, no,
Jacob told me he listens to most of the podcast on twice speed. So he gets through it.
So well, yeah. Like, really? I'm like, yes, we can laugh at ourselves. This
can we collaborate and all agree to talk really fast for the rest of this episode? So that way we really
don't have a problem with that at all.
Yeah, no problem.
I've never had a podcast.
We can all talk fast. I check up the Eric's right now.
Half the stuff that Lauren says sounds normal.
I know, apparently I talk really fast.
All right, let's listen to just a little bit more because it's
abolishing it.
Daylight savings or
daylight savings?
It is daylight saving. Florida's trying to get rid of it.
Yeah.
Really?
Daylight saving.
Saving time.
Because it's starting. Sweet.
I feel like this was recorded at 4 a.m.
Or November.
I just read an article.
There's the article.
Florida's trying to get rid of it.
There's been pushes, legislative pushes to do it.
That's you, Reds. Then you were part of it.
No, I didn't say Florida. I just
getting more conspiracy.
Daylight saving
time. Now I doesn't remember.
Can you say daylight savings time in 16 seconds? Is that us laughing?
No.
It was for the farmers. It was one of our forefathers.
Forefathers.
So the Lauren's tears instead of glasses right now.
Oh my gosh. Lauren's
just crying.
Oh, that is the funniest thing I've ever seen.
Lauren's trying to remember who came up with daylight.
Benjamin Franklin.
Yes.
Oh, that sounded normal. Benjamin Franklin.
Very good. That was what was in my head, but then
she don't get a point for that.
Yeah, I should get a point.
It sounds like 4 a.m. Also, Rince, I dare you to listen to this half speed now.
Yes, I will. Oh, I bet.
Most of the time, people like Old Ben. Came up with. So.
That was like a free sound
this
print.
This weekend. Change your clocks better early or just put up with not getting enough sleep.
Oh my gosh, it's so
March the 12th, which is Monday, is Fanny Pack Day.
Oh, yeah.
And I had to bring that up.
Oh, God.
Eric is very excited. Do you have fanny pack?
Do you have fanny
packs? Hippa packs?
What day is this again?
Hippa the month.
We can't talk about it.
It's a fact. Here are your medicines. Oh my god, my face hurts.
Yeah, so the kids will wear them like in the water park.
Oh my god.
They call them what
day?
Monday. Fanny packs are popular again.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, I'm not gonna have to.
Oh my god, that's amazing.
There's I don't know that I'll ever listen to us now at regular
speed.
I'm gonna
have extra tenders tonight after laughing so hard. That is so funny. Yeah, Jacob said something. I honestly forgot about it. He was worried we'd be offended. I was like,
I was like, who would be offended
by that?
Gold. This is gold.
Oh my gosh.
They think you sound dopey now.
You're exactly right.
You didn't say a lot. I'm going to have to listen to the whole thing when I drive.
Because you guys were really taking over the conversation. I was kind of sitting back. And
I'm sure you have a lot to say about fanny packs.
Did you know?
I have nothing to say about fanny packs. Or fanny packs.
Or hips
for your medicines.
Can I just say, though, that I have a friend who, like, anytime she actually goes out to the bar in Bloomington, she wears a fanny pack. And she's just like so cool and outdoorsy that nobody questions it.
Like it just looks fine.
Like it just looks fine. I'm like, how do you do that?
That's
if
funny.
I wore a fanny pack out, everybody would be like, hey, nerd.
Yeah.
Yeah. They'd be like, don't talk to that guy.
What are you doing? What?
Oh, that's so funny.
That's a mistake. Oh,
so our apologies.
Florida. Thank you for indulging us.
Yes. But somehow it fit with Florida that we would.
I feel like we're slow again.
That we're really.
It just feels just like. We're
all right. Well, let's move forward right now. We have a sweepstakes going on called Make the Best Memories Sweepstakes that's on the Hollow blog. And you can enter daily through April the 2nd. You could win 4 one-day tickets to Holiday World and Splash and Safari, plus 2 overnights in a holiday cabin or cottage, rather, next door at Lake Rudolph Campground and RV Resort. And I did ask the Pod Squad to take a look at some of the entries because we do ask people as one way to enter to talk about what's their best tip for making the best memories when they visit the park. Did anybody have a favorite?
I had a couple.
Me too.
Same. Okay, Eric.
Well, Tim Wheeler said, pace yourself. If weather permits, go straight to Splash and Safari when it opens. It'll be less crowded. And that's a great tip to go to the water park first thing and then pop out of the water park when it gets really busy and try the dry rides because they'll be less crowded or less busy. So I thought that was a good tip. And keep in mind, there's some really good long tips on here that were really great reads. I just picked a few of the smaller ones. But get a locker. You want to have your phone camera with you to capture some photos and preserve the memories, but you don't want to have to worry about it all day. Lock it away and spend some time together just enjoying the park together. I thought that was interesting in this day and age. Just create memories without worrying about, did you get the right picture? Mm-hmm. And then somebody else said to take a lot of pictures. I thought that was good.
It kind of goes back and forth. Yeah. You can take a lot of pictures to put your phone away and just go have fun.
Yeah. Somebody else. Oh, one more thing. Somebody else recommended... where did it go? Love Holiday World, the Holiday Cash Card, which is our Holocash, is a must in the water park. That's a great way to not have to worry and spend and make memories just having the cash on the Holocash band.
Right on your wristband.
Yeah.
And we should put a little PSA in for if you do carry your phone / camera with you throughout the day to make sure and do not take it on the rides with you. Right, Eric?
That's right, because we won't find it. Likely.
Right. Don't take it on. There are signs. There are messaging.
It's very dangerous.
Messages of all types.
Want to be serious
saying,
for a second.
Don't do it. Right. And we mean it. And so please don't think you're funny and hide it in the pocket. Boy, do I sound like an old lady. Don't think you're funny. But it's, don't be hiding
it. Everyone has a ride up at the coaster.
Everyone thinks they're invincible and there's nothing.
No.
When someone loses their phone, they crumble. And let me tell you, we're not going to find it on a mile worth of track on Voyage. We'll look, but we're not going to find it.
Right. And we don't ever want anybody getting hit.
And you're not magic.
Seriously.
Oh,
your pocket isn't magic. It's not going to hold it.
Yeah. And people are different when they don't have the phone, so.
And there's that added hazard of if you're in a front seat and it flies out of your pocket, there's a good chance.
That's a very serious.
And that's that's why we take it
We don't just not have it because we don't want you to lose your phone. There's a serious risk there.
We try to protect other people, too.
Yeah.
Right. Very good. Lauren, what have you got?
Deep there.
I liked the tip that someone said, always go for at least 2 days if you're out of town. You won't want to miss a thing. Yeah. And I think that's so true.
Yeah.
There's so much to do. I mean, especially if you're only coming for once the entire summer, you got to take 2 days. Mm-hmm. You're not going to be able to do everything in one day. You're just going to be rushing and it's not going to be fun. Mm-hmm. So I liked that one. This was more of a fun one, but I liked the one that said matching Holiday World shirts for the family.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, all right. I also liked make sure you go to some of the shows.
Yay.
Yes, of course.
And then just because it made me smile, I liked the one that just said hashtag blame Eckert.
What?
That was an entry? What? That was an entry?
Yeah.
Can they win? Can they be chosen at random?
It's totally chosen at random. Yep.
That
as long as
so
you haven't,
funny.
As long as you're 18 and older and haven't won from us in the last 12 months, at random. Blame Eckert.
Those are my
works
picks.
For me.
That is so cool. I'm
sure. How about you, Eckert? What you got?
Well, I like the one we talked about earlier about making sure you just leave your phone at home.
Yeah.
And enjoy the family. You know, we're getting ready to go on a trip next week with our kids, and that's something we've told them is you're leaving your phones behind. We're not going to mess with that. We're going to actually talk to each other.
Are they going
to
do it?
They said they would, but we'll see.
Where are you going?
We're going on a cruise.
Oh.
So that'll make it a little bit easier.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, if they bring it, just fling it off.
Throw it overboard.
Side. Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Lenny's got to buy a new one for him. I was like,
no. They can buy their own. Get a job.
Well, we had an issue with that
still
earlier.
Still hiring.
Because Abby got one of the new iPhones. I think it's the 8 or whatever. Because said it was water. No, it was the 8 or something. Oh. But she insisted that it was waterproof. I'm like, it is not waterproof. There's no
it's
such thing
resistant.
As waterproof. Yeah. She's like, that is waterproof. Well, guess who took it in the pool with her? Yeah, it wasn't waterproof. Nope.
Yeah. Replacement? Did you have the insurance?
Yeah, she had to pay for it.
Really? Because nope. I have dropped this one into a fountain at Disney World, but I grabbed it right away and it was fine.
Well, clearly she didn't grab hers quickly enough.
Did she intentionally take it in the pool, like swim with it?
Was she proving something to you?
Who knows? Probably. But yeah, so we faced that issue before.
So
we're not going to have this happen again.
I bought the phone where they did the commercial where they're answering the phone call in the fishbowl.
Yeah, nice.
Have you tried that now?
I have not.
Is that a life proof?
But one of the reporters I talked to,
no,
was it this past summer
Samsung.
Before, said that her husband had actually done that, like put the phone like the fish tank and it worked.
Wow. I got to get one of those.
Yeah. The one where they're pouring champagne on the phone and the commercial.
Back in the day when it was just about
watching.
That commercial.
I love that so much.
But then it always comes out, it works for them, but it won't work for you when you try it.
Oh, right, right.
Oh, yeah, exactly. I'm not testing it, but it's nice to know it's there.
It's nice to know.
And they're like, Michelle, she said, worried about the kids getting sunburned. Don't worry about sunscreen. They got you covered. Adding cost of drinks in your budget. It's included in the cost of the park. Just come and enjoy Holiday World where memories are made.
Oh,
so
very nice.
Yeah.
We've got you covered.
Yep. And we got you covered. So I like that.
A delinquent.
Bring your oboe to make memories.
That's right.
Bring your oboe.
A lot of the tips are about having what you can do. You know, we provide a carefree visit here. And if you get a locker and you use our free sunscreen and have free drinks, you can spend time with your family and make memories.
There's lots of mentions of our freebies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was nice too. I thought it was funny that some people were like planning out ahead of time and let each person decide what their most important ride is. And so if some people were super organized and other people say, just go
with the
on
flow.
The fly.
Yeah.
Just go see what. So it's just different personality types, but we're glad.
Hey.
I wrote one down, actually copy and paste, thank goodness. But Linda wrote, in 2009, I began taking my two boys to Holiday World. That year, we stayed 3 days in the family cabin. The looks on their faces was pure happiness when we walked in. We rented a golf car that weekend, and I remember looking back and at them and seeing how happy they were. This is over at Lake Rudolph Campground and RV Resort. On the way home that weekend, I said to both of them that I love you. My youngest spoke up and said, I love you too, Mom, all the way to Holiday World. Like all the way to the moon and back kind of thing.
Aww.
And well, to this day now, at the age of 14, it's still our little saying. I ask him, do you know how much I love you? And he says with a smile, all the way to Holiday World.
Aww.
Yeah. Oh, Leah, you okay over there?
I'm just going to go cry in a corner now.
I know.
It's like we're gonna I'm not crying, you're crying.
crying, you're crying. So very neat, but it doesn't get you extra points. It's just like, sorry.
Ooh, I like your
really,
angle.
Some really sweet.
I like the angle.
So keep entering the sweepstakes, and yes, you can enter by simply saying hashtag blame Eckert, and you have just as much of a chance of winning as Linda and her two darling boys. So we will see what happens, and good luck to all. This running through April the 2nd. It's time for Give Me a Number, Matt Eckert.
Give me a number. All right. So yesterday we had fire extinguisher training for our staff.
Did everybody do that?
Yes.
Go out and grab a fire extinguisher and put out a fire. That's
How many fire extinguishers do you think we have in the park?
Lauren is raising her hand.
Well, at least the guy yesterday said we have around 365.
And that is the number he gave out, but that was not correct.
We don't have that lying to you.
Rude. I feel so.
I will let you take a guess based on what you think it is, not based on the lies of others.
Will you tell us? Will you tell us higher or lower?
No, it's whoever's closest.
But I'm just saying, from that number.
It
is higher or
lower. It's lower than that. It's got to be.
But I'm impressed that you were listening, Lauren. I think she should get some sort of points for that. I take fire extinguisher training very seriously. Yes. And on Facebook, we have a little video. We did a little Facebook Live. The second I started doing it, I was scoping it out, watching the wind direction, everything. So it's like, I really like to get the coasters in the background, but I want to stay out of the, you know, the blast of the.
Yes.
And the winds changed right after I turned it on. So if you listen to the audio, you hear me yell at Casey because it was like, when he put it out, it was like, oh, Casey, because it just blew it. It was all over my phone. It's like, I think I inhaled it.
Oh, no.
When I was yelling, Casey, if I would have kept my mouth shut.
It's going to put out the fire inside you.
Yeah. So anyways, back to the guess.
Sorry.
I'm going to guess 2-7.
Oh, he's in half speed again.
You take so long for everything.
It's I don't hear anybody else guessing.
358.
315.
300. All right, Eric won.
Yeah!
286.
What?
286. Really?
286. That came from Karen this morning.
That guy was so wrong.
I was mathing in my head. I was
30
mathing.
Suppression system. So if you want to, that's not really a fire extinguisher, but.
Well, now I'm questioning if we have. I'm kidding.
I was doing math. I was like counting buildings and rides.
Does that count the?
Were you really?
Does that count the grease fire ones too?
That's the suppression systems. Yeah, that's that's not counting those. There's 30 of those.
So those are around the.
No, she's talking about the different type of extinguisher, right?
Yeah, the grease fire ones.
Oh, the fire extinguisher. Yeah, that includes all the extinguishers.
All right.
There's ones. There's special ones in the kitchens.
There are. Yeah.
And in the
smoking
at the roller coasters.
Oh yes. Yep. And there's different ones in the smoking sections, too.
Yes.
Well, those are water, but at least that's what they say.
I think you need a special prize for knowing so much.
I mean, I listen. I feel so lied to now.
I know, right? So next year, if he says that, you can call him out.
Say we have 200 and not whatever it was.
Yeah. You're right for that. 86.
All I know is I won.
True. That's all that matters.
That's all that matters.
Wow.
I love that you say rude. At least once an episode. Insert of rude. And you say it perfectly. We are Holiday World and we love holidays. And guess what? March 29th, coming up next week, is Smoke and Mirrors Day.
Ooh.
I thought I'd bring that up so we could talk a little bit about the new show coming up
this
summer.
It's kind of appropriate when it is. Yes. And
do you want to tell us about it a little bit?
We're going to have a magic show.
Cool.
Really?
Yeah. Yes. We'll have lots of singing and dancing and large magic tricks. Yeah. So not
large. Magic. Yeah.
No, like sleight of hand.
I don't think so. I don't know. I don't know. I mean, like, I don't know all the details yet. I will know more likely at least after next week, because next week I get to go to New York and see the show, but there won't be magic tricks.
Mm-hmm. When are you going to be there?
Tuesday through Friday.
I'll be there Tuesday.
Really?
Should do something.
I'm going to see Mean Girls Tuesday
night.
Never
see each other.
Are you really?
Yes.
Oh.
One of our former entertainers
see if you can
is
get
in
tickets.
It.
Oh, really?
Just log on now.
Oh, okay.
Sing it.
Chris Medlin.
Cool.
Yes. Mm-hmm. He worked for us back in 2013.
Mm-hmm. Very neat.
If you're bored, come up. Yeah. I'll be in White Plains. You can come.
I'll just hop it right in the car. And
March 29th is also my parents' 60th anniversary.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's impressive. Kind of sad this is on Smoke and Mirrors Day, though.
Yeah, what is the subtle meaning of
this? Let's not overthink that one. Right?
I think your mom, you had your story about your mom getting you to help clean. That was kind of a...
Yeah, she's all about Smoke and Mirrors, right?
Very, very clever woman. And then we'll also have a magic show, Don Baggett's son, correct?
Yes,
be here
absolutely.
Earlier in the season?
Yes, Brandon. Yeah, he'll be here at the beginning of the summer as well as at the end of the summer. So we're looking forward to having him and seeing, what new things he brings.
So we'll have magic to do all season long.
Seriously.
Magic is very in.
You like magic, but it'll be totally different, right? Like from what Brandon does to what is in the summer.
Right.
It'll be completely different.
Is magic like ever out?
I don't think so.
I think it's just really big, right? I think it's like very popular for like the younger generation.
Getting a renaissance right now.
Yeah. Yes. A magic renaissance.
That's what Don says in his show.
Does he really?
He did last year.
He was right.
Clearly, you guys didn't pay attention. No. I only saw
See,
it like 50 times.
See, now I
want
to go back and listen to this at half speed. More yelling at us. That's all I told you. I can't think of anymore. I gotta go listen
Sounds
to
like
this.
Sounds like it was half speed.
In this show. That's exactly.
They want to hear that.
I know. That's what I
want to
hear.
I don't want to hear that at all. April 1st, as we all know, is... Oh, I wrote down April Foods Day. I guess I was thinking about Tammy. April Fool's Day and my little grandson Cameron's birthday.
Oh, he's six. April Fool's Day. Yeah.
And yeah. Easter.
And Easter.
Yeah, and Easter. And
what does French call it? It's like poulet or it's like poisson something.
That's fish.
Oh, we went through this last year.
Oh, we did. Okay, never mind. Just re-listen.
Yeah, just go back to a year ago and we figured it out. I think we figured it out. Then. Did we ever figure it out?
Something poisson because it's a fish.
I saw it's fish.
You put the picture of the fish on someone's back as a joke. That's what you do.
On Easter?
On April Fool. It's like on April 1st.
Those French are hilarious.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
Those French are hilarious.
Yeah.
They really are. They know how to go
real crack
time.
There.
They love Jerry Lewis.
It you all. Got fish on your back.
Would you like some fromage with your poisson?
What did you just say? Do you know what
you like some
say?
Cheese with your French?
You did very good.
I know French.
Yes. You do?
I took it for 7 years.
Seven years really? Wow. The best
and
you can do.
And I can say
do.
Cheese
and you
with
say
do you really need anything else?
Poutine. Yeah.
You're amazing.
Pomfrites.
Incredible.
Pomfrites, yes. Oui, oui.
Parlez-vous français?
Oh, oui, oui.
Oui, je parle français.
Et tu, oui, bien.
Je m'appelle Leah.
Je m'appelle.
Just has anyone
I'm
seen
out.
That episode of Friends?
This could be a half
Phoebe
speed.
Tries to teach Joey French for
yes.
a role.
Yes.
Je boo-boo.
April the 2nd is Children's Book Day.
Yay.
Yes. Anybody have a favorite children's book?
I was obsessed with Berenstain Bears.
Really?
And does anyone remember Encyclopedia Brown?
Yes, I do.
I love that. And then like the Hardy Boys. I listened and I watched. I read.
Did
those.
You read anything?
Yeah, that was what I read.
Okay, good.
That's all I did.
I was obsessed with the series of Unfortunate Events books.
Oh, yes.
I love those.
Those were
I was
cool.
a dark child.
I was a dark child.
Did you get to a point though where it was like, oh, this is getting so repetitive?
Yes.
We got to that point.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I finished up the series. Like I was getting old enough that like,
I just had to finish the series
just because I had like been with it so long.
You invest like so much.
Waiting for the books to come out and like, yeah. But I don't remember how it is. That's sad because it just kept feeling so repetitive. Oh, and I'm like,
that's unfortunate.
Yeah.
But the new season on Netflix comes out next week.
Oh, it does.
That said, I still really enjoyed it and still that has a special place in my heart.
Any other books?
Do anyone read Goosebumps?
No, my oldest son did. Yeah.
I was terrified of Goosebumps.
Well, I guess loved them.
They were scary.
I have, I guess, two ends of the spectrum on children's book. I don't know if it's technically considered children's books because it kind of started off as children's book, but then it Harry Potter.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, right. Of course.
It started that, as children's course. Books. I don't know if it ended as children's right. books.
It got
but
dark.
Yeah, it got dark it's real fast.
Like, yeah.
I was fortunate enough to grow up with the books, like literally like.
Yeah.
Well, that's what the target was, right? The kids reading in the beginning needed something different at the end.
There was something the other day. They started back in like 2000 or
1998 or 98.
Really?
The Philosopher's Stone, it was called, remember?
I was 10 and Harry was 11. I literally like grew up with Harry.
So you could have went to school with Harry.
I could have, yes.
That's awesome.
But by the time the last book came out, Harry was my age.
Yes, that is true. Because they didn't always come out like year. Well,
so the movies
they don't
lined
age
up
the
with
same
my
as
age.
Muggles.
When they released the movies at first, they lined up with my age. And then by the time they like released the last book, I was 17 when that book came out, I believe.
Wow.
And I was like 18 or 19. Yeah, I guess it would have been
somewhere
19.
Around there.
Yeah. No, he's probably my age.
The other end of the spectrum on children's books. Well, from my childhood, I loved basically anything Dr. Seuss.
Yes.
But now that I'm reading to Sawyer all the time, which he's not really like, he kind of looks
he's
at the pictures. Yeah, he looks at the pictures.
Sure.
He's so young.
But he likes the Dr. Seuss books too, but I also like the Llama Llama Red Pajama books.
Yeah.
Those are good.
If you give a mouse a cookie, those kinds of books
too.
Oh,
yeah, mouse a cookie.
Yeah.
I like Llama Llama.
Matt, do you have any?
I'm trying to think back to when I was younger.
This was a long time ago. I don't know that we had books back then. But yeah, for my kids. So that's when the first came to mind. All three of my kids loved Goodnight Moon.
Yeah, that's a classic.
Yeah, so all three of them loved it. Like, that was all three of their favorite books. So I've read it probably 197 times total.
You can recite it without
I probably could. Yeah.
There's a version called Goodnight Lab that I was going to get for my son Thomas, who works at JPL. But when I went through it, it wasn't as clever as it needed to be. So I was like, forget it. It's one of those that's got to really
good
hit.
Good thing you didn't judge that book by its cover, huh? Good thing you went through it. Yeah.
Exactly.
So yeah, so that was because of that. That's one of my favorites.
Remember, did anybody have Pat the Bunny? Little book where they had little.
What's that?
Nobody. That was Thomas. The book literally fell apart. We read it so much with Thomas, but it was one where you turn the page and you pat the button. And it was
different textures.
Little fuzzy. Oh, yeah, the different texture books. And there are a whole bunch of different. Cool. And there are a bunch of different books, but there's nothing ever. But as a child, I loved the Mary Poppins series. There's not just the one book. It's not just the movie. It's darker than the movie. So with the new Mary Poppins book or movie coming out, maybe there'll be a resurgence in all the books.
Right,
As well as Winnie the Pooh.
Winnie the classic.
Pooh. Winnie the Pooh.
I am trying to push that real hard on my child.
To be fair, that's always been like mom's favorite.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really. So if grandma can pass
I love that ride at Disney. I love the Winnie the Pooh ride. It's so fun.
I know. I really want him to enjoy it. So I'm trying to read to him Winnie the Pooh stuff.
So he'll like it when he goes to that.
You're going to be so devastated when you go and he's like, I do not want to ride that ride.
I know. Well, lumps.
Well, it's a little trippy.
I'm really trying to force Disney on this poor child. We listen to There's a Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow.
Yes. Yes, you do.
Because I really want him to get on the Carousel of Progress and be like, I know
it will
this.
Mean more when he goes. It
greatest
will mean more.
Song ever written.
It is. It's amazing. It's an amazing song.
Where are you going to take him first, Land or World?
Oh, World.
World.
We're going there. We're going there for his first birthday.
Really? I've never been to Land.
I prefer it.
Land is amazing.
I've heard.
It's amazing. But
it's such a condensed Magic Kingdom.
I want to wait. I want to wait until he's older so he can go and experience Cars Land.
Yeah.
Because otherwise I feel like it's not going to be as fun.
We're talking about another world trip this fall, maybe.
Like how we've shortened this. when did that become a thing?
When did this become the
WDW?
Land. Jeez.
April 3rd is Find a Rainbow Day. Did anybody see the rainbow the other night?
The one right to the left of the park when you pull out of the park?
Yes. I did not.
Also known as East.
Huge. It was northeast.
Right to the left.
It was northeast.
We were on our way back to school, to the high school. My son, James, is a senior this year. So it's like every other week you've got a banquet to go to. And the academic banquet. And
it's banquet season.
I happen to be driving and I have my sunglasses on and I don't know if anybody else's sunglasses do that, but it greatly enhances a rainbow.
Yeah.
So it's look at that rainbow. And Gary, who never wears sunglasses, is like, And I was like, it's a double rainbow.
It was really wide.
It was wide. And I could see where it ended in a field. I've never seen the end of a rainbow. So I was kind
of like a pot of gold.
And there
it was right after St. Patrick's Day. So I immediately went into the Irish accent and said, James, let's pull over to the side of the road and run and find our pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. And he said, Mom, we just talked about this in physics. He said, there is no pot of gold. And he started talking about fraction of light.
Yeah. The light fractions with the water and the prism.
On the way to the academic, he goes, but
nothing is magical.
It's like, if you want to run across the field, he said, I'll take a video of you. Thank you,
son.
That
way I can match your singing Hoosiers picture.
That's
right. But it's like, well, that's funny. All right, let's go to the academic banquet. It's like this you learned.
Way to ruin it.
It was beautiful. And unfortunately, the way it's positioned, it's really hard to get a picture from the park of a rainbow. We have a couple that are really pretty, though. And of course, we have a rainbow in our logo.
Yes.
Yeah, we do.
Yes, we do.
So very cool. April 3rd, so maybe we'll find another rainbow and that'll get me pot of gold sooner or later. It is time for Ho-Wo-Po feedback.
Woo-hoo. Yay.
We heard from our friend Coaster Dean. It's been a while.
Hey, Coaster Dean.
And he forwarded an article from The Onion. Everyone familiar with
The Onion?
Yeah.
The article was FDA cancels bacon recall after finding U.S. population already ate it all.
Oh, yes, we did. Oh, the first bee mentioned, too.
So he shared that.
It's never going to happen for us.
Condolences to the whole condolences. So thank you, Coaster Dean. That was
that's funny.
That was very funny. Next, we heard from Jonathan Williams at JLWEVV. He said, Ho-Oh-Po, my favorite thing about the Banshee. Remember we were talking about the Banshee? Nice. Last time was the view at the top when it would stop up there for a brief moment. The crow's nest is my new favorite for the Indiana countryside view. So that's
good. A beautiful view. Yeah,
it is. Yes. But
yeah, the top of the, so if you can picture the Banshee where it sat, is where Hollow Swings is now. And when it would just stop that platform. So it was
a good view.
It was amazing. And I remember a couple of times, and this was before James Oliver obviously was on staff, but I was permitted to take, TV news crew with their camera, and they used to have really much bigger cameras than they do now.
They did.
And they were very clunky, and I can say from the bruises on my leg, sharp. Ooh. And so it was like, okay, Paul, as long as you sit right next to them and you're holding on too, so the camera won't go anywhere, we can do it. And I remember I'd always make them ride it. Eric's dying over there.
Ay, Dios mío.
Yeah, it was. And they'd actually stop us at the top so they could get this, you know, because this was before drones. This was
how you got up there.
This is, yeah. And but I remember the whole going around and around and around and hearing the reporter like, oh, this is a bad idea. It's like, I told you. Nobody got sick, but I definitely got bruised several times.
That's crazy.
Were there no rules in the past?
There were no rules.
There were rules, but...
It was like Europe. Like Oktoberfest. Like, have you ever seen that?
I think we got to...
India. There were...
Yeah, no,
that's right.
It's no great. Rules. It was great.
But traffic in India, there are no rules.
Were there a lot of accidents?
No.
There are cows in
they're
the street.
Just used
cows in the street.
Do you ride them?
They say that somebody said that
just lane, if you ride them?
Like lane markers are just like decoration on the pavement.
No one even.
People would stop at like a stoplight and there would be like two lanes and cars would be stacked like four wide somehow.
So they're impressive. Just suggestions.
They're suggestions. You don't really drive in them. You just kind of straddle the line and pick where you're going.
Is that left side road?
Yeah, it's left side.
Yeah.
And they also just like honk to let you know, where you are constantly. And so like I got back to America and started driving. I was like, it's so quiet.
You're shaking. Were you honking at everybody as you drove?
No, but...
Wow. I'm here.
I did fight the temptation a couple times if I saw someone starting to drift. I was like,
oh my gosh.
Has anyone, I'm ready. I'll let you know where I am.
Speaking of India, has anyone seen the movie Lion?
No.
Highly recommend it. Mike Johannes came in and told me about
really?
It.
Lion?
Our sales director. Just simply Lion.
Okay.
But it's a true story, and I love nonfiction. Yeah. It's the true story of a little boy in India at age five who, and I don't want to give anything away, but got separated from his family and ended up being adopted by a family in Australia. And years later, when he was just out of college, he longed to go back and see if he could. And he didn't even know where he was from. But anyway, it's an incredible movie. It's on Netflix right now. It's really, really
good. It's on Netflix
right now. And it's a very slow paced. So you kind of have to calm yourself down before you watch it because it's not a go, 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 go.
Yeah.
But it's.
If something's slow, I just like I'm on the phone and I'm not paying attention.
See, I know. You can't do that.
Yeah.
You
have to be engaged.
It's interesting, though.
It's really, really good. And it's something that just happened really within the last decade or so.
Wow.
So it's good. Well, glad you're back. I'm glad you
enjoyed it.
So did you actually drive or were you being driven? Okay, because that
most people in Delhi are afraid to drive.
So is it just like taxis that are driving? And
I mean, there are people who definitely have cars. It's kind of like New York where you're like, nobody drives except
everybody. Yeah, I guess I could
nobody drives because everybody drives.
The difference with New York, though, is that like you follow the crosswalk. Like you never, you don't just.
Oh, people play Frogger.
Despite what people say about New York City people.
And they put up like medians in the road. They put up medians in the road to keep people from like crossing because then there's nowhere to stand. And they just hop up on top of them. Like they get up over there and the medians are about that tall.
Where's everyone in such a hurry to go to?
I don't know.
The other side.
The other side of the road.
Yes.
but they're not chicken. I would be.
Next, we heard from Bob Green.
That's great. I just got it.
Bob05 on Twitter. I just heard the news of Big Red Icy at Holiday World. I'll bring some boysenberry taffy as a thank you.
That's such a good idea.
Bob Green.
That sounds tasty.
We got to come up with our own berry.
Our own berry?
Yeah, the holoberry. Yep.
Ah.
I would do a cross between pomegranate and...
Is that berry? I mean, I guess you can do whatever
that's
you want,
a good
but.
Point. I actually haven't thought about it yet, so I'll think about it. A pomegranate.
You work on that.
Okay. Blueberry pomegranate.
Blueberry.
With a cherry.
On top.
Yeah. Mm. The hollow berry sounds
think
delicious.
Think of that taffy.
Yeah.
All I can think of is picking stuff up.
Are you listening, Tammy Burke?
Tammy's like, I'm turning this off. Yeah. Even at half speed, even at double speed, I can't take it.
Based on what she said earlier, I don't think she's listening.
We also heard from Alexander at Coaster Spotting, listening to Holiday World Ho-O-Po while skiing at Breckenridge Mountain, Pro Slides Rick Hunter is talking about his early career ski racing, and now he's applied some of that to how he's designed water slides. So surreal and interesting at Colorado Super Chair. So how cool is it?
I love hearing that. That was so cool.
Listen to out in Colorado while
that's
you're
so
skiing.
Cool.
Yeah.
While you're skiing. Wow. You know, that would be interesting to hear other listeners what they do while they're listening as far exercising, cleaning, walking.
Driving.
Lori Cotton's trying to go to sleep. That's why she plays
it. I know Lori uses it to go to sleep.
That's what she told me.
She would really help her.
Yeah. Soothing. You are feeling sleepy.
Let's all just like whisper Lori all together.
Good night,
little Lori. Go to sleep, Lori.
That's so creepy.
Let's sing like children's songs in a minor key.
And then we also had
some really terrible nightmares. Yes. I need to go. I'm too mean.
That one was Alexander. And then we also heard from an Alexandre. So D-R-E versus D-E-R. And this was a sweepstakes entry from our spring cleaning sweepstakes. As I listen to Ho-O-Po, when I'm cleaning, if a new episode hasn't come out yet, I listen to an older one. Aww. Hashtag Ho-O-Po. Hashtag
that's really nice.
Dole Whip it is. Hashtag Blame Eckert.
Come here, thing.
Tag it is. Big Red Icy. It is a thing. Oh,
but they're blaming you for bringing Big Red Icy, so that's really good.
Yeah.
They're
so
like
blame
happy.
Is a credit.
Yeah, blame is a good.
It doesn't necessarily mean.
Yeah.
Like the blame rents thing is more of a negative.
You don't know that. You don't know what they're thinking.
I know. Next, we heard a Twitter direct message from Emma C. Mundy.
Oh, said, Emma.
Okay, I wonder if it was somebody you knew. Okay, she says, wasn't sure how to post on your wall, quote unquote, but I had taken my vocal music pedagogy test. What's that?
Pedagogy.
That's like pedagogy. Okay.
Teaching.
Okay. I didn't know. Test for Indiana. For Indiana educator licensure. Wow, it's very fancy talk. Last night, and thought about Leah saying people could break into cars and steal phones a few podcasts ago. So I hid my phone in the box of tissues in my car.
Oh, no one would check there.
Nice.
Unless the thief has a cold.
Unless they're listening and now they know. Right, has a cold. Figured out that would be an unlikely place to look. So glad I heard that on the podcast because I wouldn't have thought anything about the possibility of theft. If not, love listening to your podcast.
Thanks,
Emma.
Very nice.
Congratulations.
Oh, yes.
Did you say she took the test?
She took it.
Well, yes. I think I saw her post that she passed.
Oh.
Well done.
Well,
so,
just in
congratulations.
Case.
Congratulations.
Yeah, yeah. Like,
and if not, sorry. And I crossed my fingers for you.
Yes.
Covered all the bases.
Good job with the phone in the tissue box.
That's smart so thinking.
Yeah. Smart thinking. That's right. Late yesterday, we heard from the New England Coaster Club at Bizarro Fanatic. So we got a foot of snow again today. Oof. Thought it was supposed to be spring. Come on.
Love it.
I just want to get back to Holiday World and ride Voyage, my number one wooden roller coaster. Hashtag Ho-O-Po. Hashtag blame rents. It's your fault
fair.
We
You're
have
welcome.
Snow. Hashtag blame Eric. So I guess I'm a little more personal.
Super blaming.
Oh, the first name thing stresses me out.
So much more personal. How do you feel about that?
I'll take credit for the snow. I love the snow. They did. They got walloped in the Northeast again.
Yeah, again.
Oh, gosh.
Yes.
What was it? The fourth nor'easter?
Yeah.
The fourth nor'easter in 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I started panicking the other night when Bloomington started getting dumped on with
snow. Oh, yeah. Because we got even a little, but we're south.
Yeah.
We got.
It's beautiful.
William was here. Yeah. William was here this past weekend, and he almost didn't make it back to New York.
Really?
Wow. Yes.
It was about time he got some flights delayed and canceled. He has such good luck when he flies, and I always get rerouted. I always
have
issues.
So it's his time.
I never make it home on time. It was finally his turn. I just relished in everything he sent me.
That's funny.
Isn't it funny how something follows you through life?
This is what
you get. It's like, oh, I didn't know that was still there.
Oh, just ask my family. They don't like to travel with me if they can help
it. No, we don't.
They avoid it.
We do.
As much as they can without being completely rude.
Especially don't travel abroad with her. That's a definite no-no. Yeah.
So the trip to
domestic flights are iffy, but international
getting to India,
I worked out it and I had enough time both ways.
That
and
is,
it
was, that is shocking.
So maybe
mind you, I scheduled like 4-hour layovers everywhere I went.
Not a bad idea. Though.
That's the only way I do
That's
it.
That's like the first time you've gone abroad and it went well in like what, like 8 years.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah.
Next, we had a conversation that there's no hashtag Ho'opo, so I basically just...
Well, you just stole it.
If you're putting it on Facebook, though, you know other people... I mean, on our Facebook page, you know other people are going to read it. But it's a conversation between Cameron Luther and Stephanie Renault. R-E-N-A-U-L-T. Would that be Renault or Renault? All right. Yeah. So Cameron says, Stephanie, we're riding this summer. So it must have been... I think it was a Thunderbird video that he put up. So he said, Stephanie, we're riding this summer. Stephanie responded, remember that time we broke up because I hate coasters?
Whoa.
And Cameron said, just wait, I'll get you on it. And then a big smiley face. And then she responded with four skulls.
Oh my gosh.
Cameron said, just
this conversation's taking a turn.
Real time breakup on Facebook.
It was a little alarming. It was just, oh my. Cameron then responded, just one time. And if you hate it, never again. Stephanie responded, or never, and I don't hate you. And Cameron said, you wouldn't hate me. You love it after you got off. Girl, bye. And
then, girl, bye.
And then some sort of...
Is it emojis?
Yeah, and I'm not sure.
Can I tell you?
No, because I'm not sure that it's a thumbs up, but it was something similar.
Oh.
No, I think it's a thumbs
up. It involved
a
finger.
Is that a thumbs up? Sure it is.
Sure.
Your
middle thumb.
Okay.
Your middle thumb.
But Cameron and Stephanie, I'm sure you'll be
So am I clear? Are they back together?
I think so.
Well, that's why I'm
just
heard.
Enjoyed the human drama.
Remember that one
here.
Time you broke up with me?
Yeah,
like almost like sand through the hourglass.
And now we're trying
almost as dramatic as that one time someone live tweeted a breakup on an airplane.
Oh my gosh, I love that so
when
much.
Did that happen?
It was a few years ago, but it was most amazing thing. They were
so
sitting
great.
Next to these two people who like fought. They broke up
very vocally.
Very loudly. They
on
broke
a plane
up.
That was delayed getting off the
Yes.
They weren't even in the air yet.
They broke up, got back together, and then I think broke up yet again by the time the plane landed. And this person live tweeted the entire thing.
Oh, I love that.
That'd be kind of fun.
I love that.
You have to go look it up.
We heard again from Bob Green on Twitter, and he's got food on the brain. He wants to know he said, thoughts from the pod squad. It's bacon brittle.
I'm intrigued.
I would try it.
I would try it.
It's made in Nashville.
Yeah, I know. I saw that.
The Brittle Brothers. The
Brittle Brothers.
Brittle Brothers Bacon Brittle. Real bacon.
I hope that's their last name. Brittle Brothers Bacon Brittle. Oh, that's hard.
I know, right?
Very hard. So, Bob, we'll give it a try if we find some. It's a very colorful little package.
Brittle Brothers Bacon Brittle.
Yeah. Also, I wanted to pass along a story. With Saturday having been St. Patrick's Day, that when I saw someone by the name of Patrick on Saturday liked us on Twitter. And we probably gain, I don't know, 20, 25 a day or most days.
Ooh,
we get.
Nice.
And,
nice.
You know, I don't go and look at each one, but for some reason, the Patrick was by himself. Usually it's like so-and-so, and 25 other people.
Yeah.
This was just Patrick is following you. And it's like, Patrick, how magical it's St. Patrick's Day. So I went. Of course, and stalked him and clicked on it. And I noticed the background photo, you know, the little header photo up at the top of the page, I recognized as the college we had just visited with my son, James.
Oh.
We had just been to Rose Holman Institute of Technology, which is in Terre Haute and is U.S. News and World Report says is the number one engineering school. So, you know, put in a plug there for it. I thought, I'm going to engage with this young man.
Huh.
And so I private messaged him and said, thanks for the follow. I thought I recognized that background. How do you like Rose? I love Rose. It's been a great experience so far. How's Holiday World right now? So I said, that's great to hear. I was just there with our youngest son on Tuesday. He's days away from making his decision. Our oldest is a Rose grad too. Anyway, and then bragged about him a little bit. I can't help it. And really annoys Thomas, but anyway. But I thought I'll give him a hope because Thomas went straight to JPL. And so, and then I said, Paula, and I said, oh yeah, all is well at Holiday World. Getting ready for the start of the season. To which he responded, Paula, that's really interesting. If your son ever has any questions, feel free to ask. And he'd actually just hosted some prospective students.
Oh, that's really cool.
The night before, he said, so I think I know all the answers right now. And then he said, I'm actually hoping to work on roller coasters when I graduate. And I think Rose is hopefully the place that'll get me there.
Oh, cool.
Awesome.
Isn't life funny that way?
Yeah, it is.
So I said, that's really something. Hope you can work at a park, hint, hint, in the summers. That's the best way to get your foot in the door. I'll surely keep that in mind. Thank you and best of luck to your son on his decision and the start of the season at the park. Aww. Thanks and happy St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, that's cool.
So Patrick, nice. That was just kind of fun and to have it be somebody who wants to probably design roller coasters.
Yeah, that's wild.
There's a bunch of them out there though, huh?
Design
those roller coasters. Yeah. All right. And of course we heard from the coaster crew. Let me hand this to Lauren so you can see. This was Kitty Claus, Speak, Pause for Me.
Yeah, very festive.
And then we have, what's BGF?
Big Greenfoot.
A2 Kitty.
Yes.
You've caught us in the middle.
That's French.
No, that's Latin.
No, it's Latin.
Oh, Eric.
Etois is French. Sorry.
Et vous, probably.
Etois or et vous. Sorry.
One step forward, three steps back. You've caught us
hashtag
in the middle.
Blame my French teacher.
You've caught us in the middle of rehearsals for our own twist on a classic, Big Green Caesar and the Bacon of Doom. You see Kitty Claus? Kitty Claus.
Oh, got the bacon.
Gosh.
Bacon looks like a bacon sash coming soon to a Holiday World theater near you. Beware the Ides of March.
I was so sad I missed the Ides of March this year.
That's hilarious.
I just didn't pay attention to what day it was.
I told you.
I looked, my friend was staying with me at my apartment and she, like, I have a calendar thing where you like flip the numbers every day. Mm-hmm. And, she went and fixed it, and she fixed it to the wrong day.
Oh!
And she took it to the 14th, and it was actually the 15th. And then all of a sudden, when she said it was the 14th, I looked at it and went, oh, tomorrow's the Ides of March. And then the next day I looked at my phone, I was like, it's the 16th. I missed it completely.
Oh, no.
It's my favorite holiday.
But we went ahead and...
Not really, but...
We put some Thunderbird launch video footage on Twitter and said, beware the rides of Mars.
Oh.
That was fun. And I wore my Shakespeare shoes, so that was fun.
I like the togas that they're wearing. Yeah, that's cute. I like the little column have in the background.
Did you say the rides of March? You could have also said the rides of launch.
Oh, that would have been also cute.
Save that for next year.
Clever.
And of course we had a second. Now let me find it. Where's the other one?
Number two.
There's the other one.
That's so much effort.
From the coaster crew.
So much.
Now that's what I call a close encounter. When our visitor showed up and said, take me to your leader, Kitty was the obvious choice. We always knew she was out of this world. Don't worry, we'll be sure to bring her. So it's an actual abduction, right? That looks.
Oh my gosh.
Kitty is our leader.
Oh my gosh.
It looks kind of like
in the middle of a cornfield.
Coming down into the cornfield.
And they have a disposable camera.
But look, she's she's actually up a couple of inches.
That's
the
first
feet are. So they're
she's being abducted
into
a little
space.
I love her face.
Spaceship.
It's so typical.
And now we understand her face as she's been abducted. I will put that. This
how did they do the alien? Face. Look at the alien. Did you see it?
Yes, he's sitting on top of the Jiffy Pop.
That
oh my gosh.
Scary.
Okay.
And so then Big Green Foot has the little pointy finger now. They're using that again, which is wonderful.
Oh my
It was actually an alien abduction day. My son Thomas, by the way, used to as a child, he would not go outside after dark because he said, Mom, I really don't believe in aliens and alien abductions, but just in case. It wasn't just.
Oh, yeah.
So I wonder, I don't think that works anymore now that he.
Well, after seeing Signs too, it's like.
Yeah.
Not going in the cornfield.
Yep. So thank you, Coaster Crew. And we will post both of these tweets as well as other supporting photos from this podcast episode on the Holo blog. Did you know with our Pick Your Price online ticket discounts, you can save up to $20 per admission ticket, general admission ticket, and save a little more by using the official Holiday World podcast promo code. Eric Rents, what is that promo code?
H-O-O-P-O.
Very good. Can you spell it?
H-O-W-O-P-O.
Very good. Simply go to Holiday World.
Can't wait to hear that in slow-mo.
I know. Right?
That's what, yeah, now we're...
H-O-O-P-O slow-mo.
Oh, yeah. H-O-O-P-O slow-mo.
So go to holidayworld.com/save and drop in H-O-O-P-O and let the savings begin.
Let the savings begin.
Well, it's that time again. You've heard the theory of 6 degrees of separation, right? It's been 25 years since we opened our water park, Splash and Safari. So let's play a game called 25 Degrees of Separation. Our fed up contestants, I didn't know how to say that because we were talking about food, but I didn't know if that would work. Or
that, no, it works.
Does it work? Now that y'all get it, now that I've explained it.
I figured we were just fed up with the game.
Well, that, okay.
Sure,
our fed up contestants.
Our full contestants.
Are given.
Full of themselves.
Are not.
Sorry.
My God.
Stop trying to add corrections.
Yeah.
Or additions or improvements.
Given the name of someone or something that is connected with the year 1993 and must figure out the connection to us. Last week's or last episode's winner was Lauren Crosby.
Oh, hey.
Hey. Good job. By a landslide. You did.
By a landslide.
Yeah, so it was a landslide.
Yeah, I don't know that I got a point at all.
I got points.
Yeah.
I honestly don't remember yourself.
I don't either, actually. Was I even here for
that? Did.
You were, but I don't know.
I think you were abducted by an alien.
I think we kind of gave up.
You were up in the jiffy pot.
You gave up?
I think we both did. I think Lauren was dominating.
We're talking about the size of the
water. There's no point today.
Yeah, Lauren was here.
Lauren
was dominating, so we're like, okay, whatever.
Yeah, we'll see.
I've not been crushing every game I'm in.
We'll see. Let's listen to Soundmakers. What have you got there, Matt Eckert?
Let's try this one.
That's supposed to be like a legend reference?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I'll take it.
Ooh, it's spooky. It's better than a cowboy.
Oh, I was ready.
Oboe. Very good.
I had to teach people in a class this week about playing the oboe.
Ready?
Really?
It was a weird class.
I brought the whistle back one more time.
And Lauren. Squeaky toy.
Okay.
All right, ready? This time around, let's look at the 1993 Tony Awards.
Oh, whoa. This is so rigged, guys.
Okay.
It's not rigged. Why is it rigged?
I didn't watch those.
You didn't.
Well, neither did me and Leo.
Or if I did, I was not even three.
You had musical parents.
I know. I was like 4 and a half.
You probably have it on VHS.
I'm so old we didn't have a TV.
Probably.
Then we proceed.
Sorry, Paula.
All right. This was a musical. This was nominated for Best Musical for the 1993 Tony Awards. The Who's Tommy.
What does that
so
mean?
What's the question?
The Who's Tommy?
What's the connection? How
does that connect with us?
Oh, okay.
The Who's Tommy. Leah.
As many people might know, our Lauren and I's father, Will Cook, was obsessed with The Who.
See, I wouldn't know.
I'm going to tell this story. One day I came out. This was a class shirt, but still, it was a similar sentiment. One day I came out for breakfast and had like a The Clash shirt on, but another day I wore a The Who shirt and got a similar reaction of my dad just looked at me and just went, I'm so proud of you right now.
Oh, that's funny.
Like, I don't think I ever got that genuine, but I'm so proud of you.
That was your
until
moment.
Until that day, that was my moment.
Wearing
but
it.
Dad loved The Who.
He did.
And he played it a lot for us.
The Beatles
and The Who.
Yep.
Yeah, that was one year, didn't we all chip in? And
we did.
That's what we got
Christmas,
him for Christmas.
Yep.
Was deep, because they both had big DVD sets, like the entire collection. He nearly cried, I think.
Yeah, we all went together.
He was so happy. You were next there, Matt.
Yeah, so I was going to go with, you know, if you work at Holiday World and Splash and Safari, everyone knows who our painter guy is, Tommy Johnsmall.
Okay.
Very good. And Tommy was on the podcast a couple episodes ago.
Tommy and I have been trading some texts the past few days because he's been giving me a hard time because UK was still in the tournament.
Oh, God, that was devastating.
Yeah, so he's like, are you going to watch it tonight? It's on at 9:47. You might want to set your DVR.
This whole tournament is such a bust.
So I texted him this morning and said, how about that UK game last night? They lost.
Ooh.
He's like, yeah, very funny.
Yeah, he's mad about that.
Guess what? Florida State won.
I know,
yeah, I did
right?
see that. Yeah, that's amazing.
I know.
It's because they're on daylight saving time.
Yeah.
On the East.
We still have an Indiana right. school and a Purdue
they
still
want
there.
More days.
Oh, yeah. Right. I can't
good
support
them.
That. I'm
yeah,
sorry.
I'm not a Purdue fan. I like the fact that we have an Indiana school in it, but.
Yeah, like I respect you, Purdue.
Yeah,
I just can't
but
support
respect.
You.
No sorry. Support, but all my respect.
I don't understand any of this.
That IU blood, it runs deep.
Anybody else?
I rang
anything?
In next.
All right.
And I,
Mr. Rentz.
I had, it was what Matt said, but now I have a different one.
Looking great.
Which is. What people don't maybe think about when they come to Holiday World, besides the free soft drinks and free sunscreen, free parking and great value. It's also, Matt's about to interrupt me. It's also the who's doing that.
Better no, than
it's also,
that was bad.
It's also that. Who's helping to provide that service. And that would be our wonderful hosts and hostess that put on a great show for our guests. And we're hiring now and we're right in the midst of that. So anyone who wants to be part of the Who at Holiday World, come on and join.
What's the URL?
I always mess it up. Is it holidayworldjobs.com?
Yes,
it is.
Oh, you get an extra point for that.
Thank you.
Oh.
Because I always say holidayworld.com/jobs, which is not the link.
But that'll also
get you. I feel like I did that once and it brought me to like the.
No.
Maybe you misspelled
did you try
Holiday World. Holiday gets turned into Hoyle Day a lot.
Yeah.
It's very
Hoyle
easy.
Day.
Hoyle Day World. Yeah. All right.
Is she ringing?
The liar one?
Yeah, Lauren's next.
Oh, okay.
I'm kind of going off of what Leah said with, you know, my dad loved The Who. He was very excited 1 year to get to go to the Super Bowl because The Who was
he went
the
to the
halftime
Super Bowl.
Show.
Yeah,
that's right.
Yes,
what year
the
was
Who
that?
Was the halftime 2000... show. It was the Colts
eight,
went
nine?
To the Super
eight,
Bowl.
Nine.
It was in Miami.
It was in Miami.
Yeah.
Who did he go with?
William. And I was really mad. I was so mad because I had actually watched every single Colts game that season. And I was I was a huge Colts fan that year.
Lauren was mad because she was the Colts fan. I was mad because I was the Who fan and William went.
Yeah.
Because you guys weren't the boy.
Yes.
Yeah.
But yeah, but yeah, that was like,
that's harsh. Yeah.
That was a very memorable.
Also, we were both in college.
Yeah.
It made more sense.
It was a very memorable trip for William. Yeah. So
did you guys have a Super Bowl party and
also,
watch all of it?
No, I just watched it with Mike in his apartment.
Yeah. I also, you know,
wasn't too exciting.
Got dad to take me to pull me off school in high school one time and take me to Heart Journey and Cheap Trick concert.
Heart and Journey. Oh my God.
Don't tell
my
teachers from high school. I'm still afraid that they're going to find out.
They can't do it.
You're doing just fine now. You're doing just fine now getting your MBA. Like that one.
I still don't want them to know.
Yeah.
Who is next?
I had one more.
Okay. Yeah. I don't want all of you.
So I want to give proper shout out since we gave Tommy the shout out. We also have another Tom, although it's a derivative of Tommy, but Tom Berg, who's been with the park for ever and ever and ever with our construction crew. We got to give him a shout out.
And
too,
he's a character. He's definitely on the short list. We got to get him on here.
Yeah, for sure. And both Tom and Tommy are part of the Who as they help us. They helped us in the water park this fall.
So who helped
Tom
us?
Tom Berg on Wildebeest and Tommy helping supervise.
That was
Can
bad.
You hear it if I smack my forehead?
He'll just stay with me. So do what you want.
Remember, Josh is by himself down there in the control room going, what's happening now? What's happening?
Josh left. He's like, I can't do after the whole slow-mo thing.
We're on our own now.
Bye. Like the DM. Bye, girl.
Drop
out of here. Bye, girl. I'm out.
Okay. But I had one more. And that was in the Halloween show. Lauren and William and I, as a tribute to dad, tried to work in a The Who song.
Oh.
And we kept fighting over like which one we wanted. And I wanted it to be My Generation and I wanted it to be My Degeneration.
that's cute.
And that's all.
What was yours?
I don't remember.
I think William wanted, did William want Tommy or did he want?
No.
He wanted Pinball Wizard.
Pinball Wizard.
I'm a big fan of Pinball Wizard.
That it would have been a tough lyric rewrite.
Yes.
Like it would have been a lot of words.
Very hard lyric rewrite.
Yeah, that's a tough. Got
to
consider
tough ones
that.
To rewrite anyway,
yes, there were.
My Degeneration was set.
No, I did not.
Okay,
I feel like that would have been such a good one.
Yeah. I feel like we've bled this one to death now.
This was pretty good. This was,
did we actually?
Last week you were
did
like,
we actually
no
get though what you were thinking?
No. Yes.
Oh yes.
Oh, who was it?
Well, I wanted. of course, Will's mm-hmm. love of the Who to be mentioned, which it was in spades, and also Tommy Johnson to be mentioned. So let's look. This is the name of a show that was up for the best revival of a play. And it may well be something no one's heard. I'd never heard of it before, but anyway, it was one of the best shows in 1993. Wilder, Wilder, Wilder.
Ooh, I gotcha.
You did.
Yeah. Mr. Rentz.
So in Splash and Safari, we're wild because we have, you know, Mammoth and Tembo, and it's all the...
Just because you say it like that doesn't make it wild.
It's still wild. It's wild. It's a wild experience, and we have a wild experience with Thunderbird and Voyage. We've got some wild rides out there. So, and we say wild times three, wild, 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 because we were originally known for our big three wooden coasters.
Oh, he's back to camp coasters again. Yep, you haven't done that a long time.
Remember how, I feel like I've said this before, but remember how like in high school, the teachers would say on essay questions, like write until you're right.
Is that what I'm doing? Well, I have one more for Voyage.
I feel like that's always how he answers these Voyage questions. It's like, let me just keep going until something comes out that seems like it might.
Well, I've got another. Voyage is the... Voyage is the wildest of all. Voyage is the wildest of all.
And
I remember when you announced Voyage, the big push on the how big and fast the first three hills were. Right. So wild, 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 really. I can do lots of trios, so you better shut me up.
Okay. Mine was going to be similar on the Voyage, like any of my friends who have come, because every person I've told at IU about our park still thinks it's like this cute little thing. Like everyone's like, oh, we've got something like that. It's called Storybook Land. I'm like,
no,
Storybook Land is cute.
You're like, bye girl.
That's cute. You really need to come see my park because no. And I'm like, and they're like, do you have roller coasters? I'm like, do we have roller coasters? We have some of the best. What?
What?
I get really braggy really fast. I'm like, get really
you should.
But the people who have actually come, like, talk about the Voyage, and they're just, like, either they love it or they hate it a little bit, because some of them are like, you know, Steel Coaster is more their thing. Thunderbird, they like a lot more. But I'm like, I feel like the Voyage, like, I'm going to say this and be really bold, and people I'm sure are going to disagree with me. But last night I said it, and I stand by it, that I feel like the Voyage pushed the wooden coaster to almost its limits of what
Absolutely.
It can do.
That's
kind of why I think the hybrid started developing. Is because the Voyage, and there are a couple in that like class.
Oh yeah,
that
time. It's the max. Like, it's the max.
It's the max of what you can do, and so it is wilder, wilder, wilder.
And only we can have it, because only we will make sure it.
Yeah.
It.
Yeah.
Is stays the max. That way. It stays. You know all the work we're doing, the 900 feet on and the return also, run.
Yeah. Yes.
It's going to be huge.
And also with the thought of the first three hills, don't forget about the triple down.
There wild, you go. Wild,
there
wild,
that's
wild,
what
wild.
I was waiting for.
I was just going to say that. I was just going to say
me
that.
So that's what I was waiting for.
I was waiting for her to finish, and I was going to say, oh, wild, triple down.
Yep.
That was what you were thinking with wild, wild, wild?
I was thinking of Voyage specifically, and really how wilder it gets during the day.
Yeah.
And at night, how it's even wilder.
Oh,
but then
I can't
how
believe it.
You do the three big hills.
The triple down.
And then
you do
the spaghetti bowl, and it's getting wilder, and then you hit that triple down.
You think you've got a break right before the triple down.
Like crazy. Yeah.
I think the triple down may be my favorite part.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
Me too.
Yes. Especially again, because there's that fake out of the break run.
I really, really love it at night, because whenever you're in there, it is like you can't see your hand in front of your face.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, I love it so much.
Triple down.
Yes. But yeah,
anybody else have anything for wilder, wilder, wilder?
Well, Leah won, so I'm done.
Oh, I'm so mad. I should have cut you off. No, because I was like, as soon as she's done, I'm just going to mention the triple down and wild, 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 and everyone's going to groan.
So for once you had restraint, and look what it did. You know?
Well, that'll
Let's
teach
your
me.
Device.
That will teach you. Well, congratulations. You've half sped your way to the end of another episode.
I can't wait.
Please join us again in 2 weeks for episode 055. Now, before we say our thank yous, we must pause to say goodbye to one of our Pod Squad members who is moving on to snowier pastures.
Those who are still listening.
Yes.
Well, for those who listen, I'm originally from the Northeast, so that's about 1,000 miles away from where I'm from in upstate New York. And back in January, I talked to Holiday World about how it's harder and harder to be away from family, especially because we work in a family park. Mm-hmm.
And
so
you have a nephew.
I know.
Was he born yet?
He was born the day before the last podcast. I wanted to plug, but then I was like, I don't know.
What's his name? Plug.
His name is Jack William Rentz. Jack was my dad's dad, and William was my mom's dad.
That's wonderful.
So really special. Actually, on the way here, I stopped at my PO box. I'd ordered like a personalized onesie. It says Jack on the front and Rents on the back, and it's got the number 18 for the year. It's so cute. I know. We would have thought I'd like babies. And you know how you're always like, oh, babies are babies, but then when it's your, when like, it's not my baby, but it's, when it's
Sire
like,
blood.
Yeah. Blood, you're your like, nephew. Oh, but this one's like really cute. Granted, I will say Sawyer is adorable. Yeah, he really is. Thank you. I'm not going to, but I've seen some babies, you know. So anyway,
and on that note,
they're like, please wrap this up.
On a high note.
Yeah, right. So we kind of worked out a plan, and I'm going to be leaving on middle of May. We're going to work through
the day before my birthday, and I want to understand the significance May 19th of that. Yeah.
Is your birthday? My birthday. Oh, I'm leaving on May 18th.
You. I know.
So bye, that girl. I can celebrate with you hardcore.
Bye, girl.
Happy birthday. Bye. So I'm going to leave in May, and it's been, there's a lot on the plate trying to wrap up a lot of projects for you guys for this year. And then of course, just some things that have been in the work, the plans for a while. So it's extra busy. So this will be the last podcast that I'm on, but I've loved the experience. I was telling Paula over text, it's going to be so cool down the road to just be able to pull up a podcast episode and like listen to us laughing about something so silly, or you know what I mean? And I was thinking about the nephew and like 10 years from now when he wants to hear about the time where his uncle worked at a park in Santa Claus, Indiana. Yeah, exactly. And I'll just be like, it'll be just cool. It's like a little time capsule. So yeah. I'm really happy to have been a part. Didn't quite make it 2 years. I realized that.
I have a question for you.
For the podcast. Yeah.
Did you get the tattoo yet?
Leah, really? I'm trying to like
trying to end on a high note.
This was supposed to be like,
we'll help you. We'll document it. We'll get it on social media when you get it.
Yes, I will.
I'm just going to hold you to your promise. I'm here to help.
That was the initial reaction was he will do anything to get out of getting that tattoo.
No, that's not why.
Back to New York. You can stay.
That's not why. And I'm actually going.
I won't hold you to that.
I'm actually leaving on Saturday to go visit. I haven't met Jack yet. That's why I said I'd be right up the road in White Plains. I'm going to visit for a couple of days and then come back. Yeah. And we got a lot to do before May. It's very, very busy, but it's been awesome. And I can't wait to, I'm going to continue listening. We should thank the listeners. I can't believe how many people you give us the numbers sometimes. And it's like, all those people are hearing us.
Yes.
So
I do have to add that Matt wanted to make sure it was perfectly clear that this has nothing to do with those 3 o'clock.
The 3 o'clock.
Like we didn't even get to have our 3 o'clock meeting.
I was like, listeners, we just had to at 4 o'clock. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, no. So it'll be, so I can't wait to continue listening and follow the park and see everything that's going on and watch Tembo. And I'm excited. It's going to be.
And it's great that you'll be there to watch Jack grow up.
Yeah, that's really, I mean, that's what it is. We, life is short and I don't want to miss moments. And it's, if you asked me 5 years ago, if I had to choose between two loves, family and what I love to do, I think I can travel and you're kind of invincible, but then you get to a point where you're just missing too much. And I mean, everyone understands with their families close here. So it's a tough decision, but it's the right one.
We support you.
Thank you.
We'll miss you.
The right decision for you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
Who are we going to have to blame?
Right.
I know.
You're still blaming me.
So apparently.
More than ever.
I'm not here to defend myself.
So the hashtag remains.
Everyone's excited. They're like, podcasts are about to get shorter. They're about to get
less editing to do.
I'll be sitting at my parents. I'll be like having a drink and I'll Twitter notification. I'll catch up on Twitter more.
That's right.
And I'll see a blame rant in the middle of July. What?
You'll stay.
I'll stay caught up. That'll be my new, that'll be my mission. Spend more time with family and stay current. Be a current tweeter.
That's amazing.
That's right. Twitter I'll use my GIFs.
Well, it's been fun and we shall miss you and we'll stay in touch. Yes. You never know on a Friday morning if your phone rings. You never know. Might be catching up with you.
Yeah, of course. If you ever want to call, I'd love to talk.
So we want to say thank you to Josh Moore for making us sound good today. He went solo today because Steven's off for another week, and he'll be back for the next episode.
If he's still down there.
Well, yes. hello, Josh. So thank you, Ho-Ho Coco, for making it work today. Thanks to all of you for listening. Please subscribe and leave a review on iTunes, Spotify, Google Play Music, YouTube, etc. And tell all your friends. On behalf of our pod squad, Matt, Eric, wipe away a tear, Mommy Lauren, and soon has her master's Leah.
Yeah.
Right? Thank you. Be sure to send us your feedback and questions on social media using the hashtag
HoWoFo.
Girl, bye.
Bye, girl.
You've been listening to the official Holiday World podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.